So how do you easily remove those annoying objects and people in your photos using Lightroom? Well, in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to do that very simply using the new Content Aware feature tool in Lightroom. How to use it, where it falls short, and my thoughts on that coming up. My name is David Johnston, and on this channel, I help you improve your photography using tools and features like this, both in the field and in post-processing. Let's just jump right into this and get to this feature. So what I love about Lightroom is that they constantly add features to this. So I'm just gonna go to my develop module here. And what you have is this beautiful scene, but then is ruined by this falling rock sign and even a little bag of trash over here. How do you easily remove those? Well, this new Content Aware feature tool uses artificial intelligence to remove that and fill it with something that's artificially placed in there, like surrounding elements, trees, shrubs, bushes, and even color tones. So I'm just gonna zoom in on this fallen rock sign. I'm gonna go to my healing option here, which is like a little band-aid icon. And the first thing you see is this Content Aware remove feature. It looks like a little eraser. You can change the size. You'll see if I pull it up on my screen, you can see a big circle with a crosshairs in the middle. You can increase or decrease the size using this little slider, or you can use your left or right bracket keys on your keyboard. What I've seen work on this best is if you get the circle just slightly larger than the object that you're removing so that it has just enough information, but not so much that it's trying to fill massive amounts of areas in this. You just want it slightly larger like I have on this sign. And then all you do is click. You'll see an analyzing icon come up. And that's just deciphering what objects are around this and how can they fill that with artificial intelligence. So you'll see what was a sign is now an actual shrub here. Now, if you don't like the shrub that it placed here, what you can do is there's a refresh option, and that's going to update that spot with a different artificial intelligence fill. So I'm just gonna hit refresh, and that's gonna analyze that section, and it's gonna come up with something different. Now, I actually like that first one, so I'm gonna hit Control or Command Z to put it back where it was. Now, you can also scroll over to these other two things that are in here. It looks like a rock or a piece of trash, which is very unfortunate, but I can just come over here, fill in with that section. It's going to analyze, fill that with some shrubs. I'm gonna click this, it's going to analyze, and it will fill that with some objects too. Now, again, what I'm doing is having that circle just slightly larger than the object that I'm trying to replace. So let's look at this before and after, what it was with the sign and the trash and what it is after and how the Content Aware did. So on the left is the before and on the right is the after. So I can just zoom in on the bottom here and we can see that it did a really good job filling in that fallen rock sign. And then on the trash part, it did another great job filling in those areas with natural shrubland around those. Now, obviously, this has done a really great job filling those areas in. There are some key areas where this doesn't work very well, and I'm gonna show you some workarounds on how to try to fix that coming up. But first, the question of the day, I wanna know, are you using this feature in Lightroom? Are you just using it in Photoshop with some advanced features? Let me know in the comment section below, and be sure to like and subscribe to the channel if you're getting a lot of value out of this. So what are those areas that you don't see this work very well? Well, with large people and objects, sometimes this falls really short. I'm gonna show you where that occurs. So here's a photo of somebody that was in the way of my shot when I was photographing some sand dunes. So I'm gonna go to the same healing tool. I'm gonna have my brush just slightly larger than this person, which is tough to do because their tripod legs is standing out a little bit. I'm just gonna have that zoomed out, try to get them all in there. I'm gonna click and it's going to analyze that section for me and find an area that fits best. So here's what it did here. And you can see that it doesn't always do the best job. When this happens, you can hit the refresh option. But that doesn't always work. Like we saw, the refresh sometimes isn't the best option there. And you can hit refresh over and over and see what it does. Or what I like to do is just try to make it work as best as possible. So I'm gonna zoom in on this a little bit, scroll over to where that actually was, and just see some of these sections that maybe weren't the best at the content aware fill. I'm gonna go back into my fill options, and I'm gonna bring in some of these other tools here, like the clone stamp. I'm just gonna reduce the size of that stamp size with my slider over here. Gonna reduce that down to something really, really small, and I'm just gonna come in and remove that extra little tripod leg that maybe snuck in. Maybe come in on this side and remove that little part that came in. And there are also some of these shadow features that came in on the area as well. I'm just gonna come in and try to remove those as best as possible. Sometimes it picks areas outside of where I'm trying to go. So I can just scroll up and see where it actually picked and bring that back down into the sand dunes and come down here and fill this area in. So there's a lot of legwork that can go into this, just trying to get these little areas, and you can fill it in as best as possible and try to make that work. Like, I'll zoom out to the max area here so you can see, and we have fixed it a little bit, but it is pretty obvious where that actually was. So you can fix this, and there are workarounds to get around it, but sometimes there are situations where this won't work. Now, where are situations where it does work when you're removing people? Well, that's when those people are actually very small within your frame, like this photo that I'm gonna show you. So here's a photo where this person snuck into the very top. I'm gonna go to develop, going to zoom in on that little person and go to the healing brush, clone stamp aware. Now, one of the things you can also do is click and drag this tool to kind of highlight around them and make a custom section. And it's done a good job. There's a little bit of a peak that it brought in that's kind of strange right there. Just gonna do the content aware, and it made this really cool sand dune peak right there. Now, the last thing I'm gonna show you on this is how to actually select your own area where it's going to fill from. You can hit your control or command key and click and drag a square of exactly where you want that to fill from and have that refresh and artificial intelligence fill from a specific area. And that can really help you out when you are doing something like filling an area that has a lot of different tones. You can select one out exactly where you want it to fill from. Now, if you want more Lightroom tutorials that are gonna help you improve your photography, you can click or tap this playlist that's gonna help you do just that.